This video is brought to you by Saraswati Vidyala Union. And hi, this is Prapti. Today we are going to study about Biology Practical Standard 12. Now let's see in detail. Hello students, today we are going to study about the Biology Practical. In this Biology Practical, in the last few lectures, we have seen about the major and minor experiment. Now we are going to study about the part B, that is about the spotting. So in the spotting, for your examination, spot A, spot B, spot C, spot D, spot E, spot F, spot G, spot H, spot I and spot J will be there. But what is the spotting? Spotting means what? See, in the diagram, means in that picture I have already shown, means that specimen will be in front of you. You have to observe that species, you have to identify and you have to comment on that species, means you have to write down few points related to that species. Okay, that is only known as the spotting. Now in this spotting, in today's video, we are going to study about the spot eye. What is the spot eye? Now let's study in detail. Spot eye. So on the spot eye, in the examination, the teachers will give you name the parts or the part indicated by marker in the model or chart and enlist their functions. So in front of you, model or the chart will be there. So you have to write down the function of that particular part of that VS of ovule. Okay. Or for this, the or is there, that is identify slide on bar body. Okay, but here we are going to study about the anatropous ovule. So what is the practical today? So that is study of VS of anatropous ovule through a permanent slide or relevant chart. But in this, I am going to show you diagram. Okay, now let's study. What is the aim? The aim, that is study of anatropous ovule and functions of its various parts. So this is the anatropous ovule. Now what is the anatropous ovule? Anatropous ovule is what? That is the inverted ovule in which micropyle is directed downwards and present nearer to the funicle. It is called as the anatropous ovule. Okay. Now you observe orthotropous ovule. Means there are various types of ovules. For example, orthotropous ovule, amphitropous ovule, hemianthropous ovule, then campylotropous ovule. But here I am going to distinguish between the orthotropous and anatropous ovule. Now orthotropous ovule means what? The ovule in which hilum, that means funicle, chalaza and micropyle lie in one straight line. It is called as the orthotropous or straight or erect or the atropous ovule. So this type of ovule you can see in the polygonum as well as the rumex in this plant. And here in this practical, we are going to study about the anatropous ovule in detail. So we are going to study about the parts of the anatropous ovule in detail. Now let's study. See, in this only we have seen anatropous ovule, that means it is the inverted ovule in which micropyle is directed downwards and present nearer to funicles, that is known as the anatropous ovule. Now here the body of ovule get fused with funicle along its whole length on one side, and in this micropyle lies close to hilum. Chalaza and micropyle are in the straight line. Like this is the basic structure. Now the parts of the anatropous ovule. This anatropous ovule has two parts. First one, that is known as stalk or funicle, and the second one, that is body of ovule. See the first one, that is funicle. Funicle, the stalk of ovule, it is called as a funicle or funiculus. It may be long, short or absent. The ovule with funicle is called funiculated ovule or the stalk ovule, and the ovule without funicule, it is called as the sessile ovule. The point of attachment of funicle with the
body of ovule, it is called as the hilum. Funicle attaches ovule to the ovary wall by placenta. See, in inverted ovule, the funicle remains attached to the body of ovule beyond the hilum, forming a ridge that is called as raphe, which persists even in mature seeds. This anatropous ovule has vascular strands and supplies nutrition to the body of ovule. So this is the information about the funicle. Now the second one, that is known as the body. Body of ovule, it is oval in shape and consists of three main parts. First one, integuments. Second, nucellus. And the third one, that is the embryo sac. Or you can say it is a young ovule consists of only integuments and nucellus. That embryo sac is not present in the young ovule. Now, in this body, the first part we are going to study in detail, that is about the integuments. The nucellus covered by one or two protective covering, that is called as the integuments. The ovule with one integument, it is called as a unitegmic, and the ovule with two integuments, it called as the bitegmic ovule. In most of the angiosperms, ovules are bitegmic, that is with outer and inner integument. See, in the diagram also, it is already shown there are two integuments are there, so that's why this type of ovary, this type of ovule, the integument which is present inside it, as per that, so this ovule, it is known as a bitegmic ovule. In some plants, ovules are without integuments also. So that type of plants are known as the ategmic ovule. For example, santalum, loranthus, in this plant, it is the ategmic ovule. Now the second one, that is known as the chalaza. If you observe ovule in detail, so the base of nucellus, from where the integuments arises, it is called as the chalaza. And the end of ovule where chalaza is present, it is called as the chalazal end. Each ovule develops as a small projection called as the nucellus over the placenta. Now the next part, that is known as the micropyle. Integuments surrounds the nucellus from all the sides, except at the top where a small opening is left, it is called as the micropyle. The end of ovule where micropyle is present, it is called as a micropyle end. And remember this one, wherever the end of chalaza, wherever the chalaza is present, that is called as the chalazal end. Now the next one, that is known as the nucellus. This nucellus, it is the central major part of the body of ovule. It is made up of diploid parenchymatous cells. It is nutritive tissue as its cells contain food substances. Hence, it is called as the nucellus. Means nucellus are nutritive in function. It is also called as the megasporangium because it produces megaspore from which female gametophyte or embryo sac develops. Means in the starting, one megaspore mother cell is present. From that, four megaspores are produced. From that, one remains functional and the others get degenerate. Okay, so this nucellus, in this, the next topic, that is the embryo sac, it is also called as the female gametophyte as it contains female gamete or egg. It is large, oval-shaped cell present towards the micropylar end of nucellus. It is embedded in the nucellus and embryo develops in the cell, hence it is called as the embryo sac. See that in few plants, in few ovules, this embryo sac is absent. Okay, so if you observe this embryo sac in detail, you can see that inside it there is a presence of 7 celled and 8 nucleated structure. In that, the first one, that is known as the egg apparatus. So it is a group of 3 haploid cells present towards the micropyle end of the embryo sac. In this, at the center there is the egg cell, and side to the egg cell there is a presence of synergids. Means what? It consists of central large cell called as the egg or female gamete, and two lateral cells are called as the synergids, or this is also known as the helper cells or sister cells or the cooperative cells. Each synergid is characterized by the presence of finger-like projection called as the filiform apparatus towards the micropyle end. It directs the pollen tube by secreting chemical substances and absorb nourishment from the nucellus. Now, you observe the next topic, that is a secondary nucleus. A diploid cell present at the center of embryo sac. It is called as a secondary nucleus, or it is also known as a future nucleus, or it is also known as a definitive nucleus. The two polar nuclei fuse in the center to form secondary nucleus. Now the next topic, next part of the anatroposophial, that is known as the antipodal cells. A group of three haploid cells present towards the chalazal end. It is called as the antipodal or the antipodal cells. These are vegetative cells and possess number of enzymes, lipids and proteins. Like this is the about structure of anatroposophial. Now functions. Now we'll see functions in details. Functions of various parts of ovule. In that first one, that is funicle, it gives support to the body of ovule. It supplies food and water, that means nutrition, to the developing ovule. It attaches ovule to the placenta of ovary. Now next one.
This next topic, that is known as the integuments. This integument give protection to the nucellus and embryo sac. After fertilization, it develops into seed coat. And many times what happened? So this pollen tube enters inside this ovule through the integument. And when this pollen tube enters inside the embryo through this integument, so that time it is known as the exogamy. Now the next topic, that is micropyle. See that wherever that integument is not present, so over there a small opening, that is known as the micropyle. This micropyle allows pollen tube to enter the ovule during the process of fertilization. It allows entry of water during germination of seed. Then radical or root at the time of germination comes out from these only. And many times what happens, this pollen tube during the fertilization, this pollen tube enters inside it, inside the nucellus, inside the embryo sac through this micropyle. So that time, that process, it is known as the porogamy. Now the next topic, that is known as the nucellus. This nucellus, that functions of nucellus, it provides female gametophyte at maturity, and it is nutritive in function. Next point, that is known as the chalaza. It allows the pollen tube to enter the ovule during fertilization. So whenever pollen tube enters the ovule through the chalaza, that time it is known as the chalazogamy. For example, walnut. So in these plants, so the type of chalazogamy taking place. Then this chalaza, it produces integument from the basal part. Now the next topic, that is known as the embryo sac. This embryo develops in the embryo sac after fertilization. And this embryo sac, which contain the 7-celled and the 8-nucleated structure. In that, now let's study about the types of the cells. In that, at the micropyle end, egg cells and the synergids are present. Now let's study about the egg. This egg cell, after fertilization, this egg convert into the diploid zygote. Then synergids. Surrounding means at the side of the egg cell, that synergids which are present. So it helps to give entry for pollen tube containing male gametes within embryo sac. After that, antipodal cells means the cells which are present towards the chalaza. So these cells, after fertilization, they degenerate and act as a nutritive tissue. And now the next and the last part, that is known as the secondary nucleus, means what? After fertilization, it convert into triploid primary endosperm. Nucleus which produces triploid endosperm means what happened in this second male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus here, and it forms the that is known as the triple fusion. So here the process of triple fusion takes place and it nourishes developing embryo. So that is the function of secondary nucleus.
Like this in the examination, either chart will be there in front of you or the permanent slide will be in front of you. So you have to observe and you have to write it on few points related to that. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, comment and share my video. And please subscribe my channel. My channel name is Prapti Vansare. Thank you.